Hallo liebe Sivus-Fans und herzlich willkommen zurück zu einem neuen Spielerinterview mit mir. Ja, die kalten Tage sind so langsam vorbei und deshalb freue ich mich natürlich umso mehr, dass ich mich heute mit Philipp Schkobay hier draußen treffen kann zu einem Interview. Ich hoffe, ihr seid alle gespannt. Kommt mal mit, wir treffen ihn jetzt hier direkt vorne. Hi Philipp, nice to meet you. How was your day so far?
Hey, nice to meet you too. Yeah, my day has been great. I'm excited to be here for an interview and yeah, let's have a good time.
That's nice. So you have been in the team for 3 years now. Yep. And you moved here when you were just 16 years old. So how you perceive the development of the team in the last years?
Yeah, that's true. I've been here for 3 years now. I moved when I was 16. And yeah, I think the development of the team and myself has been really good. I've always been able to follow and I've just been excited every single day to go to practice and for the games. I really liked it.
That's nice to hear. So, would you say you have developed parallel to the team in the last years?
Yes, I would say so. I mean, the steps our club and the team has taken are huge, immense. I really have been giving my best to follow it, and I think that I've developed myself as a person and well as a player every day. So, yeah, I could say so.
Really interesting. One of the first news this season was that you're going to go to college at this beginning of the next season in year 2021-2022. So how do you feel today with this decision?
Yeah, that's true what you are saying. Yeah, the news maybe came as a little shock for somebody, but yeah, I've always dreamt about going to college and always something I wanted to do. So kind of the decision was pretty clear for me. I really, you know, I've always gonna support the Sivus and have the city in my back. And I think it's something that I will never forget. And the decision, I still stand by my decision. I think that's the right one to make for my future and yeah.
Do you have special things, like how do you prepare for college next year? Do you do some special things for it?
I wouldn't say do special things, but I mean, like I said, I've been preparing my whole life for this, and it's always my dream. So I try to follow the guys who already been there. We got a couple guys from the team who's playing college basketball, and I just try to have as many as advice as I can take from the coaches as well as the players. And I wouldn't say anything is like really special, but it's just like ordinary and really wanting to give like your best every day.
But you just told me you're working hard on yourself, like you preparing and train a lot, and you are really good at school and you learn a lot and stuff like that. You told me you just have 1.3.
Yeah, I don't have my Abitur done yet. Yeah, I'm making my Abitur yet. So, but I mean, I hope I will finish with those numbers. That's my goal at least. I really, you know, want to focus both on my school as well as my sports. And I always thought it was important. And I really, like you said, work hard in both. And I really think that's something that will help me, you know, move forward as a person as well as a player.
Yes. I have the question, what is about your family? She moved with you to Rostock 3 years ago from Sweden. Do they stay here in Rostock when you go to college?
Yeah, I mean, as many of you know, my dad has been the coach, so we always have been moving my whole life. So I actually haven't talked really in the family what our next step will be. We have more focused on what like the decisions are right now, especially with the pandemic going on. It's maybe a little bit hard to predict the next couple of years. But I would say, I mean, my brother goes to school here, so I would say our family's first priority would actually be to kind of stay here and, you know, support my brother as best as we can.
So you always will have this connection to Rostock?
Yeah, I mean, I will always. Rostock is something that high school is kind of like one of the most important years, so I would say high school is, especially in Rostock, is something that I will never forget. I'm kind of grown up, and it's nothing like when you're a kid that you forget stuff very easy. So I think Rostock will always be something in my mind, especially also sports-wise with Stadthalle and the fans and everything.
That's nice to hear for me and the fans. So what do you think you will miss the most about Rostock?
Yeah, like I just mentioned, I mean, yeah, it's kind of a hard question because I really don't have one thing I would say. It's like the whole lifestyle, the people that I met. I mean, most of the people I met have been really friendly, helpful to me in everything, in both school-wise, sports-wise, or just hang out and have fun. And I've been really good taken care of, and I think it's something that I will miss, the people actually, the fans, my friends, and just everybody, the club, the school. So I would just say, yeah, the experience all in all, and the lifestyle.
So, but when your family stays here, you will come back and visit Rostock. So we're gonna all see him again, guys. Then thank you for your openness and your honesty, and I wish you good luck in college in the USA, and of course a successful last season with the Rostock SeaWolves this year.
Yeah, thank you very much. I hope so too, and I hope we can make the fans very proud this
we
summer.
We already do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you a lot. It was really nice to meet you.
Thank you. Same.
Goodbye and see you next time.